So consensus is the way that the XRP ledger solves the double spend problem without proof of work. Kind of the problem is that we can all agree on which transactions are valid or invalid. The basic rules for a transaction are simple. They have to be properly signed. You can't send money you don't have. Those things are all not a problem. The problem is if, let's say, Alice has one XRP or one Bitcoin or $1, we want her to be able to send that to Bill if that's what she wants to do. And we want her to be able to send that to Charlie if that's what she wants to do. But if she can do both, we have a huge problem. So somehow, even though both transactions are valid, we have to agree on which one of them we're going to put first so that we can agree that the second one is invalid. And so it's that problem of resolving conflicting transactions. Now, historically, that's been done by a bank. Like if I write a check, my bank either says I have the funds or I don't. And if I write two checks for the same money, they'll process one first and we'll all agree that the one the bank said was good is good. But we don't have a central authority. Bitcoin uses proof of work, Ripple doesn't. The XRP ledger uses a distributed agreement protocol, which is essentially just a way of everybody to say, hey, I saw this transaction first. And if you have a supermajority of agreement on that and no way to renege on that agreement, that is sufficient to order the transactions. That combined with the deterministic validity rules is enough to say that the one that we agreed comes first is valid, and the one that we didn't agree comes first forever invalid. One of the things that we realized very quickly when we started to experiment with consensus and see what it was capable of doing is we saw that it had several advantages over proof of work. And some of them are fairly obvious, that you don't need to spend millions of dollars just to keep the blockchain secure. You don't need to suck money out of the ecosystem to send to power companies. But there was another one that's a little bit less obvious, which is that you don't have a dictator who gets to choose what's in each block. Each block is, or its equivalent, each ledger, is determined by a consensus of participants. So there is no single party that gets to determine each block. That's what makes possible some of the features that the Ripple Ledger has, like the decentralized exchange, the arbitrary assets. Those things require a system that has inherent fairness rather than people who get to decide the outcomes.